yards. Dr. B, if we just get started on the right shoulder, looking at it from the back to the front, everything you see is magnified 30 or 40 times on the screen. I know you're kind of an old pro at this, so we're going to go through this and just show you the anatomy. Here's the biceps tendon. Looks good. We'll look at the biceps anchor. Those are normal wear and tear changes. That looks great. No signs of any significant problem there. We're going to rotate the camera, look around towards the back of the shoulder. That looks good. Again, some generalized arthritic changes, but nothing significant to worry about. Here's the leading edge of the subscapularis tendon. Here's the anterior labrum. And those structures look good. We're going to rotate and look at the rotator cuff tear, which is right here. This is the hole in the tendon right there. That's what the ultrasound showed us. Remember, we didn't get an MRI scan, we only had the ultrasound, but our sensitivity and specificity with that is well over 90%, just like an MRI scan. So I'm glad we saved it having to burn a couple days to get an MRI scan and then come back to the office for a diagnosis here. Okay, so we're going to stop there. We're going to get to work because most of our work's going to be in the subacromial space. Okay, so here's the rotator cuff tear. The back of your shoulder, posterior, is where this blue cannula is coming in. That's called the dry dot cannula. I've got a little instrument here that allows us to remove some soft tissue and stop any bleeding. You can see how that works there. And then to the front, as we move back, you can see there's your biceps tendon. So we know we're at the front of the supraspinatus. There's the biceps heading out down the shoulder. Okay. And so this is the tear, this is the hole. And so we're going to go ahead and get to work on placing a suture anchor in. We're going to take a spinal needle and check our angle here. That looks pretty good. So there we can see how far back we've got to get. We're going to place our first anchor actually. Probably more a little posterior like this. There's one anchor right about here. There's the articular margin. We do not want to place an anchor right there because we're not doing a double row. So we're going to place an anchor back a little bit. You see the lateral aspect of the footprint is way over here. So we're basically going right in the middle between here and here. We're just going to put this right about there. So I like that spot. And we're going to make a little incision in the skin. So hold that still. Place a little guide into the shoulder. You can see it's made out of metal. And now we'll get this in position again. And like we talked about, we want to place it very solid. We're going to reach in from the front of the shoulder and we're going to use an instrument called a crochet hook. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and look at these sutures and decide which one we're going to work with first. I think I'll go ahead and take this black and white stripe one. So you can see how we bring that out. Thank you. got one suture coming out through that great cannula. We're going to put a grasper in that great cannula right now. And we're going to use an instrument from the left side of the screen called the suture hook. You can see the suture hook here. It's loaded with a black wire called the super shuttle. And we're going to look underneath the tendon here and make sure that we're getting... width of it. See that there. That looks like that's where it needs to be. So we're going to hold this reduced right about here. And I'm going to get a good bite as far posterior as I can, and right over here. That outside your shoulder. Pause with the button on the top of the scope. Okay, so now we've got a good loop going around the cuff. Okay, now we're going to tie this right here. We'll see how this brings down the tendon. Lock this down by throwing multiple half hitches behind it. Just like that. And then in just a second, we'll flip the suture tail. Slightly different So I've got a slightly different angled suture hook. See, it's got more of this right turn to it. I'm going to look underneath and reduce this about like that. There's our first hitch coming over here. And we'll go. Second stitch coming out through the cuff. We're going to get in here and get the partner suture. Like that. See how both of those are there? That's going to be our next stitch, but we're not going to tie that yet. We're going to tie that after we pass the next one, because if you tie that one, it's going to get hard to see. So we'll show you some more in just a minute. Okay, so now we're going to get the next suture. This blue and white stripe one. bring that into this cannula. But what's different here is that this time we're going to tie from the front and retrieve from the back. So here's our retrieving tool. And our suture hook's going to be turned the opposite way now. You'll see it open through there. So see how this one now turns the opposite way. So we're going to reach in here and grab the hook. You don't want to go into the bicep tendon, so make sure you don't. We've got all three sutures passed. We've only tied one of them though. You can see the other two waiting to be tied, just lined up there. I'm going to go ahead and tie that down right there. Okay, so we've got all three tied. That looks pretty good. You can see how it's spread out. The sutures are spread out. As I rotate your shoulder, that's keeping your cuff down. We've got one more last little trick up our sleeve here. We're going to take a little punch and use this to access the bone marrow. We're going to make some little vascular channels in the bone because this will release some of the bone marrow elements, including some stem cells and other growth factors. So we'll tap on that. Just different. Okay, great. So there's one. And then we'll do another one over here. Okay, and so what that does is it releases the bone marrow, and sometimes when we do stem cell injections, that's all we're doing. We're getting bone marrow and concentrating it. Okay, so there we've got three holes. Look at that. When we turn down the pressure, you can see it looks like fat starts to come out of those holes. It's actually bone marrow and all the good things that are in it. So we're going to finish up here and get you back to the recovery room shortly, okay? Good luck to you now. Let's see if we can see some of the marrow come out. Just starting to come out here. Excellent. So, as we evacuate the water, it'll be even more obvious. Okay, so good luck to you now.